District Council, of course, welcome you to Clacton. One of our younger visitors, unfortunately, has lost part of her hearing aid, and it's a really important part. It's gold coloured. If you find it, please could you hand it in to the police? Thank you to them for being here in such a great number today. The police tent, or indeed take it to the nearest It is auto gyro. Quite an interesting little machine, this. And pizza in a big coffin, which is a massive glass coffin. Can see the crowd really clearly. You can see it really long. So please do not wait as you see Peter passing along Clacton season, because he will see you and he might even wave to us if we're going to.
It's such an interesting aircraft. It takes off like an airplane and it lands like a helicopter. It really is quite the contrast. In the simplistic view, it doesn't
pardon me.
We need a total parachute. The rest place of the gyro can be free wing in this flight, being driven solely by the air going up through the brakes disc. There's no mechanical drive to the rotor in flight, and the phenomenon of auto-rotation drives them. Once it's airborne, the rotor disc can pass themselves into spinning, even if the air speed is showing zero, which Peter will demonstrate for us this afternoon. The propeller of the aircraft pushes it through the air before the flight, and the rotor will come slightly back. And the airflow is up through the disc to keep the rotor spinning. It's simply the rotor spinning through the disc. It keeps on turning even when flying sideways or even backwards. But it's going to fly backwards, deliberately. As the rest of the aircraft hang up in the rotor, it acts like a pendulum giving the gyrocopter natural stability. The rotors, which are the wings of the aircraft, are flying through the air at 350 miles per hour. So turbulent, unstable air, the wind gusts are sampled. This gives the gyroplane much more stable, but most aircraft aren't capable of flying in conditions like that. It's called an auto gyro, but can be referred to as a gyrocopter, a gyrocopter. There is huge fun to see and great watch, great fun to watch. And Peter will be assuming that he's the only gyrocopter that is able to do an aerobatic routine. He's wagging his tail at us, he's smoke billowing out. He can very much see you, so make sure you give him lots of big waving this afternoon. And if you're lucky, you may even wave back at us.
Or something like that.
Stepping back to America now with the staggering.
It's only Team Raven and Red Arrows left.
Aircraft that we've been really excited about this afternoon. It's our first, I think, Clacton airshow. An aircraft that was built in the States, of course, the operation from
only Team Raven, I think, I'm sure.
Flying into and out of the Old Farm airfield today, so inland in Essex, so maybe you caught sight of this wonderful pair of staggering
airfields.
Oh, so we get a good view, and get a good look at these winds, these second winds. And back in the day, the winds aircraft were more of a height and watch.
Yeah, they're them beach ones I was talking about. Yeah, we saw them at Duxford, didn't we? But there was a red one. They look like the windwalkers, don't they? They're meant to be like that. Yeah, but the windwalkers are better because they got a noise to them. To be fair, the windwalkers are better. This has got lemonade in it,
isn't it? Actually, the burgundy aircraft
No, it's nice, don't get me wrong.
I've done it. Seems to be. Yeah, I got it wrong. It's two more after this. Team Roman and Red Arrows, I think. Yeah. Forgot about this one, to be fair. Yeah, I don't think we're going later. No, I'm alright. I don't know where I'm going to be with Charlie tomorrow. Wherever he wants to go, I'm just going to say. I bet he goes up the pier.
Just like a tutor that we saw much earlier on today, so, you know, pilots, we're also
started their career by pirates living out of the air, and they are quite an affection to see them fly, because for a lot of them, it's where they will literally cut their teeth. Now these are six very experienced pilots from Southfield and the 8th Aircraft. They've been going for very nearly 10 years. Next year will be their 10th anniversary. And the process of their flying operations has just commenced. They will disassemble their flags. The information that we're going to see today is
I can hear the plane again. I can hear something in the air. I don't know if it's part of the air show or not. I'm at home because I couldn't be asked to walk home from the pier. I was meant to be at the pier. You can hear that. I don't know if that's the Thunderbirds or the parachute plane. To be fair, no, I've got a clue. You can hear something. It's the parachute plane, I think. But I don't know where it is. You can hear it, you can't barely see it. You should see Otto and the Thunderbirds, but this plane's invisible. At least you can hear it. They have them again, they have the parachute plane again for some reason. And I think I should have the red arrows this time, and I think, or something like that to come for the night time. Yeah, I can hear that big time. It's over there somewhere. No, it's not. It's not even part of it. Unless that is it. Was the plane going that way? It's nothing to do with it. That's a jumbo jet. That's nothing to do with that, but I'm sure that plane there might have been to do with it. No, because it's more like going, it's more going over there. You want, it's more wants to go that way if it's part of it. That's, that noise there is not part of it, but that little buzz and could have been. Yes, jumbo jet, nothing to do with the air show. Not sure, don't know. What was it? What can hear something again? I've got a feeling it's over that bit. You meant to have three displays. You meant to have the parachute tiger team, Otto, and Thunderbirds. You might see the other two, but this plane's not even visible. Thought I'd bloody see it. That blue day. Should have gone up. I should have not grew the fuck up and walk home really. If I'm right, you know, you can hear it, but you can't see it. Well, that was it. Displaying now, just saw them. It's raining, so I went inside. The window's not open, you can't hear them, but they were displaying a minute ago. Back over this way, it's typical, isn't it? You meant to have Otto. Yeah, I don't think that's here, I've not seen it. It's only there for the night time and then it's going back wherever it comes from. I don't know where it comes from. They all come from different areas, don't they? Areas. You see that? It's the Firebirds. Outback Twister team, they used to be called. They're from Newquay. The past part of a field near Newquay. We are from different places. That's a long way for them to come, though, to be fair. I'd say 3 hours probably. Bit less than, yeah, because compared to a car, it's longer, isn't it? So I'd say take the few hours, probably 3 or 2 hours off, or the hour off. I'd say 3 hours from probably to get here. From, because it's mainly about 7 or 8, isn't it, from driving, but. Nearly bad to see that, it's just. They look better. They look good now. Like earlier, they were a bit, you know, I've got them again. I've got them twice. Didn't film the red arrows. I'll be filming that tomorrow. Because my phone needed charging. There you go. Can sleep better like that. But they look back now. They maybe at night time they have to be. Got it displayed out again. Maybe it's just where I was standing. No, it's like they were. Hey, there's fireworks coming out of the planes. You can see that? They're like spaceships like that. Shame you can't hear them. Don't think Grotto's here. Grotto, I keep saying that. That one's there. The little helicopter is, but the one with the small face on it. That's not here. Oh, there's another something going on over there. That could have been Otto, to be fair. Yeah, but it's not here. These are the only ones what are parked at the airfield. I think the parachute one was, the pip one was, and Grotto. Auto Grotto, it's called. But these are the Firebirds.
I think it's in Du Mort night time as well. They can hear him a little bit there. I couldn't be asked to walk back, that's why I'm at home. Don't think I will be filming the air show again, probably. It's probably the last, because I did one last year. It got deleted off. I still got Duxford one on there. This one, I hope it's not an hour, this one, for a change. It's just a shame you can't hear them, because they look good like that. They're a bit boring earlier, I'm not going to lie. They're more for the night time. I don't know why they display in the daytime. Or they could just do it a last display, well. Was out there now. Grotto. That wasn't at the airfield. Otto. Fuck's sake, it's over there. Sorry for my language. Done quite quick. Done well. I think I've done well. Yeah, look, it's Grotto. Otto, right there. Funny looking helicopter, isn't it? Yeah, that weren't at the airfield today. It's only there because it ain't there tomorrow. It's only there for the night time. Yeah, it does little fireworks. Well, it's clever how they do it. Clever how it does that. It's like a little fucking meteor, isn't it? And it's another plane landing at the airfield. Yeah, the two firebirds. I want this to be thunderbirds, but it's in the fucking tree. Like a little meteor, isn't it? You can't even see the helicopter. Maybe it ain't. Maybe they've got something in the sky doing it instead of Otto. That'd be cool, to be fair, but that's just not fair, because Otto's just not here at all. I'm not sure, because you can't. I'm sure with Otto, you can see it a little bit. It's like it's nothing there. It's like it's a little ball. No, it is. I can't tell, because it's like a ball on fire, isn't it? Don't know how they would do that, but from the fireworks. But it came from the right, so that can't be, because if it come from the left, it'd make more sense. Where's the planes, man? Where it is. Don't worry, I'm not filming you. This is different, this is their property, innit? They told me to put the camera down, I'd say, sorry, I'm not. That's different. Yeah, people were like, looking, thought I was filming them and I wasn't. This is different, it's their property, but I'm just filming the, trying to zoom it in. It's zoomed in, it's how far I can go. And yeah, I'm just filming Otto, the last display for tonight. Really? I think it's done now, I'm not sure. I think it's better tonight than it was earlier, to be fair. No, they did have good displays on, don't get me wrong, I just, yeah. Yeah, I think he's done.
Thank you.
shape of a typhoon, I think that is. That was. Thank you.
this bit's the best.
other aircraft in flight. And it's been doing that role for, as I say, over 60 years, coming into service in 1957. And there's no plans to completely replace it with the Pegasus just yet. Studies show that they could be flying the Strato tanker until 2030, so another 7 years of service, making it one of the rare aircraft to be in military service for over 60 years. It's getting closer. We're looking to our left. If you're on the seafront, over the pier, look to your left.
Noisy, this one,
as we welcome from RAF Milden Hall in Suffolk, a first for us here in Clacton.
It's not the Vulcan.
Making a very slow and graceful entrance, just about reaching Clacton Pier. Here she comes. Cameras at the ready, please, as we welcome the Strato tanker. It's a beast of a Boeing aircraft just flying over the boats that we see in front of us. And with a protruding prong at the back, Sam Williams.
Absolutely. I mean, it's the first time I've ever seen anything like this, and it really is quite a beast. And it was quite a pioneering aircraft because it was the United States Air Force's first jet-powered refueling tanker, and it replaced an aircraft called the Strato Freighter. They've all got quite exciting names, haven't they, Ian?
It does sound very grand, and such a long service, over 60 years of service.
Absolutely, and the KC-135 is actually tasked with...
Hi Ken, from the Norwegian Air Force Historical Squadron. And we have a pair of Strike Masters, as Sam says, flying out of North Wales today, led by Mark Petrie. Just in her wake alongside. is indeed the vampire that will be seen on the big screen. Look out for the John Travolta movie. It's an adaptation of the Frederick Forsyth novel, The Shepherd. As you see them camping around towards the sky, the Scoutmaster's with them, lighting up, camping around. Beautiful view of the marriage. These are beasts, aren't they? They are so intimidating.
Absolutely, and what really gets me with these is they're just a bit low. Good to have those vampire really was quite beast. Its maximum speed is 548 miles per hour. Looking up above the beach, we've got the aircraft flying line stern. On up to the other small train wing as we head above the wind farm.
Looks her age at all. The Havilland Vampire first flying back in 1943. That's 80 years ago, isn't it?
Finally, by 48
of the Vampire appears round the Harrison Vampire, we get a proper look at
the lower of the do that, though.
This Paris Strait Mouse is great to see them here from Northfield, so come from Essex. Not too far, I shouldn't think it took long.
The old to ones, like, well, the recent ones.
And now the tree leaving the Strait Mouse to Paris, originally from Paris, going back to those in the 70s. In Scotland and tornadoes in the Falklands. He set up his own military aircraft aviation business in 2001. He was flying a private jet pilot and working on a maintenance company. He then joined the Sherrys, like many of them, display pilots who likes to fly Boeing aircraft. And he trained on the 777 when it first launched.
Our radio air show listener Alan, who worked for Rolls-Royce, will be no doubt listening to the Rolls-Royce Viper turbojet engines in these Strike Masters. The crew of two. That's correct. And we can fly in one of the Strike Masters in today's display from nearby Northfield with LA Legends. So we've got a few kids there.
It's how they used to be. Maybe people prefer them like that. It's better. But it just starts to come in like that, and I'm like, I think the red arrow is crazy. Explain. From Wales, aren't they? These two. Umpires from
Mark
the Netherlands.
Is a great fan of Clacton, who says that the Clacton air show is like a natural amphitheatre here. It's got air displays. And he loves displaying the strike masters. It's got lots of power. Flies about 450 nautical miles an hour at about 515 miles per hour. He loves displaying here in security. This is a very tight display with this aircraft because of its power. Get up close and be able to see the crowd. Interesting thing about the Strike Master is only
design, and to me it represents that kind of real era of jet power fighting up there. Some close passes there, getting rounds of applause from the spectators down here on the beach.
Yeah, I think some fire will come in there.
There's some pretty big gulls as well flying just in front of our commentary point. You can see them are sizing up chips as they go along. So if you've got your chips or your ice cream on the beach, keep them peeled for those gulls.
Sure,
they're just waiting for an opportunity for a snack.
Waiting to pounce, just look at the Strike Master would have done when it was out in operations. And ice centre stage, the aircraft are coming up to us. It just reminds me of going on holidays.
Monkey boy.
Historical air squadron. Thank you.
Christmas. I'm so pleased that Alpha's come back for a moment in the spotlight by herself. We've had that formation flying with the Scoutmaster there. Now the Vampire joins us for our finale to the Clacton Airshow 2023. And my words, we're getting some great manoeuvres here. And I cannot wait to see that filming style alongside John Travolta. Going to the place in Norfolk in the end of the day. This patch is a groove. I just couldn't find the sky to see the Vampire.
Ken Art Pieces flying the de Havilland Vampire FB52. It's a nice between the white ones and the white ones.
It's had a little bit of a fracture for this year to mark the centennial of its Italian Air Force. And so, happy 100th birthday to the Italian Air Force this year, 2023. So, if you do see a little bit of red, white, green on the Vampire, if you've got a fantastic lens on the camera, then you can say happy birthday to the Italian Air Force. Number 1 year, many years ago, might have been at Southend actually, we had the Italian version of the Red Arrows coming to the 60s, which was the Triple Aero.
They're great fun. I've seen them at the Air Force
project, which is a team. And I see the right foot of the sky, you see the vampire, and even higher, you see a elevator on the Clacton roof. Back towards London, but a little lower, of course. What an amazing sight!
Ken, this is a very passionate member of the Norwegian Air Force. He's taken the squadron to preserve excellence in historical aircraft, to keep them in air every condition, allowing them to display them to the public at air shows and around the UK and Europe. Ken is very passionate about educating the importance of aviation in aviation and hopes to preserve, maintain, and operate them in the years to come. We've got a lovely collection of aircraft from the Norwegian Air Force's aircraft.
No, it does
pop up here. We've got two Vampires, the 255 two-seater, the FB52 single-seater. We've got a MiG-15, which we've seen displayed at Clacton in previous years, and a Canada Air.
Yeah, you have been there for the last 2 years, haven't you? You've been there for the last 2 years, haven't you? That
was a good scene. And of course, the Vampire's in very capable hands. He's got so many years of flight experience. He joined the military in 1981, and he's got around 15,000 hours of flight experience.
I think that could be the goodbye wave of the wings. And
victory roll on the way out.
Go back to Netherlands now, isn't it?
Beautiful. Bathed in sunshine. We say goodbye to the Vampire. Clacton, let's hear it for not only Ken and the Vampire, but all of our aircraft today. Let's have a huge round of applause.
That was good.
You've been good better than that.
Back. Been to the Clacton Air Show. Air Show's finished. Program. Yeah, it's a bit of a weird one because I had to film 2 days. This took, well, bits of, because there was like like it was just Vampire and Strike Master yesterday, and today it was two Strike Masters and the Vampire, but that the one at Duxford. And I think today was better. Friday, this is Friday. The rest, most of it was on yesterday, but the Red Arrow was at from today because that might have to charge. It's good, to be fair. It's good. I thought it was better than last year's. I think they ended it quite good with them, like the Jets. Shame it wasn't the only fight of Typhoon, but, you know. They do want them to come, but I just don't think they see the point, because they only get money from these, don't they, really? Or you get them taking photos of the army. That's what they get, really. Everything else goes to Clacton, doesn't it? Yeah, this is... goes to them, and the £5 I spent goes to the planes. That's just not a lot, is it? Do you know what I mean? We don't pay to go to it, like Duxford, as the previous video. Check it out. It's weird, isn't it? Clacton Airshow and Duxford and Clacton. Should have been another video, but don't get me started on that one. But yeah, should be interesting, because yeah. Hopefully I'll be going to different air shows next year, because I don't think I'll be filming Clacton again. It's for that one time, and then... Or if I see... I might do bits and bobs, but different... No, hopefully I can go to other air shows. Difficult to get to them, but... Locust, no, even that's quite far. So, yeah. I just want to end the video right now. I'm knackered. Not really eaten, to be fair, because I'll... getting stuff at home, so oh, it's so hot, it's just so annoying. Yeah, I'm gonna go now. I hope you enjoyed the video, and hopefully you enjoy the next one. Stay tuned.